I think when we have a discovery, or at least an insight, right, it's really, it's a moment of epiphany, and it's incredibly thrilling, because for a short amount of time, maybe only that one person in the world knows this idea. I completed my medical training at Harvard Medical School and PhD in biology at MIT. At the time, Professor Pat Brown, who ended up being my postdoctoral mentor, developed the first gene array technology to really look at the activity of all the genes at the same time. And that seemed to be a really powerful opportunity to combine understanding of genes with human disease. That experience really set my path in the field of genomics, which is really the goal to understand all the information that's hidden in human DNA, the human genome. All the cells in the human body have the same DNA, and that DNA contains the instructions for making every cell type in the body. So that is the human genome. And in the past, people were really thinking about genes that would end up giving instructions for making proteins. That's called the coding part of the genome. The coding genome was only 2% of the human DNA. So there's actually that whole other 98% that we all carry. That is the non-coding genome. That was very mysterious, and that became the goal of my research program. One of the main contributions from my lab is the study of a class of genes called long non-coding RNA. In our study of the non-coding genome, we realized that there was a class of RNAs that did not go on to make instructions for proteins, but instead, they were part of the process that helps us decide which genes turn on and off, but also to remember that information when cells divide. Many people are studying it, and there are actually tens of thousands of these long non-coding RNA genes that some of them have very important impacts on human health. One of the surprising results that we found was the relationship between these kinds of long non-coding RNAs and autoimmune disease. So autoimmune diseases collectively affect 50 million Americans, and 4 out of 5 patients are women, right? So there's a very strong sex bias. And we discover that this bias comes from the second X chromosome that all women carry, and a specific RNA that's only made from the second X chromosome. This RNA is called EXIST, and I think the key experiment that we did to discover this RNA was that we were able to create a male mouse that expressed this female-specific RNA, and then this is enough to make this male mouse get female level of autoimmune disease. So this proved that you actually don't need female sex hormones. You don't even need the second X chromosome. Just this RNA has a very major role in causing autoimmune disease. We really hope that the discovery of EXIST RNA in female-biased autoimmune disease will have an impact on both diagnosis and therapy for autoimmune disease. And that's what's really exciting, I think, to all of us in the field. The two aspects of my lab, they're really intimately connected. One aspect are the DNA switches that decide when and where genes turn on and off. And we also discovered that long non-coding RNAs are actually what the cells use to flip the switch in the endogenous developmental process or disease process. So the discoveries are in fact intimately linked and in parallel. I'm very honored and humbled by this recognition of the Lurie Prize. I really admire many of the previous winners, some of my scientific heroes. So it's really a tremendous honor to join their ranks. And also to give thanks to FNIH for this incredible honor. I think my most important legacy will probably be actually the students and fellows that I have the good fortune to train, because they're going on to actually develop their own research programs and making huge impacts out in the field. I really hope that some of our discoveries will have a lasting impact on in changing how people think about disease processes, and then perhaps then leading to new diagnoses and treatments.